Hello everyone, it's getting pretty serious in the McLaren garage because this is round 18, the penultimate round in this blundering series. We're in Brazil and it's getting very close indeed. Fifth place in the championship at the moment is Massa on 183. Sixth is Alonso in the Ferrari 171, but he's too far away now. We are going to muck about with the setup a little bit because qualifying only comes sixth. I'm in fourth on 207, 16 points behind Webber, so I'm a bit vulnerable. And there's three cars ahead of me. Vettel for Red Bull on 209, second my teammate Hamilton on 217, and the race leader or championship leader Webber on 223. So he only needs a handful of points really each race. He doesn't really need to win them and he's going to end up being the champion. Now, pole position was got by Mark Webber as well, with a stunning 111.5, just quicker than Hamilton on a 111.652, and I'm sick from 1 minute 12.2, so I've got a bit of time to find here. I tend to get lightning starts, so hopefully I make up a few positions, and then I think it might be a case of me trying to keep cars behind me, because in practice and qualifying, my tyre wear was pretty horrendous. I don't know what I can do about that, but hopefully I can get into the lead somehow and then hold people up while I try and preserve my tyres, but that's very, very risky. Now, it's a very short lap in Brazil. It's a mixture of fast straights and the other half of the track's pretty twisty, and that's where all my tyre wear is happening. It's 4.3 kilometres or 2.67 miles. Webber in pole position. The real race in 2010, the pole position was by Hulkenberg and the Williams, but that isn't happening here. And the real-life race was won by Vettel, second Webber, third Alonso. But my main competitors here are Sebastian Vettel, Hamilton and Webber, so keep an eye out on them. I want to finish ahead of them if possible, and possibly they all crash and I win the race. Sixth place is awkward, but there's a very tight couple of corners. If I can weave my way around there under braking, I'll be very pleased. So it could all end in calamity straight away, and we're off. Okay, put the throttle back on fast. Got past one of them, here we go. That's working out well. Webber's gone wide, brilliant, and I've cut the corner slightly, but I'm in the lead. Absolutely awesome, from sixth to first there. I don't know how I got away with that, but that's much better than I ever, oops. I was gonna say much better than I had it before, but Webber's come back on the inside. Oh my word, we're next to each other. Push me slightly wide, someone's going to come past, surely. Yep. I think that's Alonso coming on the outside. Come on, I'm getting around the outside, surely. Good. Oh dear, this is very risky. Alonso was very obliging there, braking. Get Webber under braking. Whoops! Man, Alonso would have loved that. Hamilton round. So a couple of collisions. That's not Webber down, well, substantially. Come on, I don't want to clip my teammate and go off. Whoa! Get out of the way, Hamilton. Deary me, sorry about that, sir. Well, that's him out of it completely. Alonso is a big profiter there. He's gone well away as I've collided into about, I don't know, about three different drivers. Look at Alonso, he's well away. But he's got no chance to win the championship. He's 52 points behind. Hamilton's coming on the inside. I'll brake late. He's got no chance to win the championship because he's 52 points behind. Now, really easy to outbrake yourself here. Let's take a narrow line so Hamilton doesn't go, or Alonso, or Vettel doesn't go, I should say. Oops, that's a bad run there. Hamilton's got going again, so he must have blocked the field. Right, so first is Alonso Ferrari, I'm second McLaren somehow. Third Vettel Red Bull, fourth Webber Red Bull, so he's recovered slightly. And I think I'm already holding up the cars behind me. Alonso has disappeared. I think we can forget about the race win unless he makes a mistake. Oh my man. Car's not holding on brilliantly. But yeah. It's all about trying to hit the racing lines. If I do that round here, it's very difficult to overtake. And if I brake late on the main straight, unless they've got a big power advantage, someone's gone off. I don't think it's Alonso. This is gonna be quite close, this. Whoops! That's much wider than I wanted to do. Yep, Vettel took a sweep there, but it wasn't enough room. Right, is he going to have a go at me there? He must do. He's going to have the slipstream. He's going to have the slipstream. Let's see what he does as we come up to the end of lap two. Is he going to dive on the inside? Let's try and make him go around the outside if he is. So I've got cars right behind me. It's Vettel, Webber and Hamilton, and I'm holding all of those up. Although it looks like Hamilton might have been overtaken by someone there. I don't know who that is in fifth place. Don't know who fifth place is. It's a surprise person. Could be one of the Mercedes. But Hamilton is stuck behind him. Which is... So there's two good recoveries already. Webber, who I collided with, and Hamilton, who are completely span round. There must be a massive gap behind them then. Everyone must have stopped to try and avoid a collision. Yeah, there is a sizeable gap there. Right. Let's see if we can wheel Alonso in. Keep an eye on the gaps as we go past the finishing straight. See how far Alonso is. My main concern for myself is at some point my tyres completely go off. But I've started on the tyres that I've done qualifying on. So these are the options. So they are going to wear out pretty quickly. I think we've got to get to either lap 6 or lap 7. Then we go on to the primes. It should last us to the end. As you can see, 21 laps here, so third race distance. One advantage I've got is I tend to enter the pits a lot quicker than everyone else. Alonso's pitted, so maybe his tyres are gone already. If he's going to come in as early as lap 4, that will help me. But I can't even see him on the map now. Oh, there he was, just going off there. He's not going away as much as he was at the start. He gained all of that on lap 1 and 2. I think we're holding the same distance. So all the question is, can I hold a Vettel behind me? Because I think the Red Bull cars are both quicker. Yeah, so the first 5 cars are away. So I've just got to keep it on the track, and I'm going to come in the top 5, I think. 6th at worst. So it's the points, but I need to finish ahead of Webber, Hamilton and Vettel, and although I'm not leading the race, I am ahead of them now. I'm not doing any of these corners perfectly. The car starts off a bit difficult to control to turn in with the high fuel lows, but gradually gets easier. I've mucked about with the ballast here, push it nearer the front to try and get a bit of front end grip. But that has had a detrimental effect on the tyres. What's that, I'm about 4 seconds behind Alonso. Didn't really go through as quick as I could have done there. Someone might have a go at me coming onto this straight looking at the map. No, I think they're too far back. Normally I'd like to swoop round here, but the tyre wear is bad. Yeah, look at that. I am holding every car up behind me. Alonso ahead. I don't think he's the quickest car on the circuit. I think he's very fortunate to be there. If he wins the race, it's because of me holding up everyone. So hopefully he gives me some of the champagne. Oh, this is going to be very pressurised for me to keep them behind. I think what's going to happen is, unless I can speed up, when we do the pit stops, if they come in a lap later or a lap earlier, then they're all going to go past me. They're all going to jump me. Are we catching Alonso? It'd be great if we could catch him. Well, it was about 4 seconds, wasn't it, on the last pass by the finishing straight. Let's keep an eye on that. Whoops, we're on the grass there. Got away with it. Okay, just try and make it as difficult as possible to overtake. The gaps were almost the same, or slightly higher. That's better than before. Still haven't shaken those people behind me. They're just waiting for a mistake. Look at the tyre wear there on the right graphic. It's red. The right rear is red. Oh, look. I can even feel the car now. It feels terrible. I'm having to go slow around the corners, but take a tight line so no one has a go at me. This must be happening to Alonso a bit ahead of me as well. Maybe not to the same degree, but when are we going to come in? I'm not coming in on this lap, so I've got to survive another lap. I feel like I want to come in at the end of this lap. I don't think the prime tyres can last to the end. Yeah, this is really slow now. I need a quick pit stop, and it's quite easy to get held up in the pit stops if anyone else is coming in. So I only wait till it's a safe release. I think there's a car right on my tail now. Right, check for anyone pit stoppers. Is Alonso in? No, he's gone round again. Pit window is open. Right, I'm coming in the end of this pit stop, and the car's going to feel very fragile around here. The danger is that a car behind me getting impatient could tip the side of my car or the back, which, with these tight bends, low downforce bends, it could, take me round or spin me. still in a chance of... Oh, very deep. Oh, I think someone crashed into the back of me there, did they? I thought I heard something. Yeah, look, they dropped back. There's a collision. Who was that? I think Vettel crashed into the back of my car there. I took no damage. And that's a shame, because that's moved Webber up. I know they're badly worn. I can feel it. If only that was Webber crashing into me. I think Vettel might have to go in to change the front nose cone. That could take him completely out. And it was Rosberg that was holding in from Mercedes. So the Mercedes car is going really well here, Rosberg. Could he end up on the podium? It all depends on what pit strategy they're on. But watch my entrance into the pits. It's going to be mega fast. Both front tyres are red there on the graphic. Rears aren't so bad. Right, here we go. Fast as I possibly can. Right, look on the position there. Fifth. Where I come back out, and it's very important. I want under 5 seconds here if possible, lads. Go! Under 5 seconds. Under 5 seconds. 4.3, that'll do us. A very quick pit stop. Right, we're sixth. Coming out in traffic is very dangerous. Right, still sixth. Still sixth. Lap 8 of 21, it's not even halfway yet. We've got to get these primes to the end, so we've got to be a bit careful with it. Right, that's great. Pit stop out into 6th place. I'll settle with that. The car a little bit behind me. It's Liuzzi in the Force India. And in front of me is De La Rosa for the BMW. He does tend to do late pit stops. I should gain on... Mind you, he's on the quicker tyre, but his tyres are... No, actually, I think he might be on the primes and then going on to the options for the last stint. So he'll be quicker near the end. Liuzzi's catching me rapidly. That's a worry. I need these tyres to warm up to get a bit of extra grip. Yep. Okay, that was great. That was great pitting, because I started on the grid sixth, made up a few positions to first, and pitted and come out in sixth. Can't afford to go off the track. Just keep it on the track. We can get minimum of six. Hopefully De La Rosa pits very soon, or Liuzzi does. He's annoying me now. Yeah, Liuzzi's in, I think. Some other cars are pitted. Where's that put me now? Up to third. Should be able to beat that car coming out. There's a long pit to come back on the track. See that white dot just rejoining it? A bit lower the bend on the map. Who is that? I think it's Rosberg. Is it Rosberg? It's Rosberg. So I'm in third. Now, De La Rosa's going to have to pit at some point. That's going to put me ahead of him, I would have thought. I'm not sure if Alonso's pitted or not. But Alonso's looking good. I'm in third place, ahead of the main competitors here. But as I say, Webber only needs to finish in the top three or four. It's still going to be difficult to beat, even if I win. Come on, let's try and get Alonso back. Well, there's two cars ahead of me. Oh, that's right, isn't it? De La Rosa and Alonso. Rosberg is catching me up a bit quicker than I would like. But, yeah, I can make it very difficult for them to overtake if I hit the racing lines. As we saw, Vettel crashing to the back and lost his nose. I don't know where that's dropped him. Pity that wasn't Mark Webber. Who is De La Rosa, was that? Hope so. Still there. De La Rosa is quite quick to close to Alonso there. He must be catching. I think Alonso might have trouble. We've got 11 laps. Can we reel Fernando Alonso in? I sure hope so. I think he's only won one race so far this season. And that's my quickest split so far, despite being on the prime tyres. So I'm getting used to the track. I am definitely closing in on De La Rosa. When is he going to pit, though? I can even see his car there. Just about. I think one more lap or so, I'll be right on him. But at the same time, Rosberg's not going anywhere. He's staying close to me, and there's a car right behind him. Possibly Lewis Hamilton, I do not know. Come on, Nick, don't mess this up. Quickest split so far. 12.6 is my quickest lap so far. In qualifying, I did a 12.2. This lap feels pretty quick, but who knows? It was quite quick. Good. Keep the momentum going, Nick. Hamilton's in 13th place. He's way down after that spin caused by me. I think if Hamilton finishes there, I think he'd be out of the championship. He's 6 points behind. Well, it all depends when where weather falls. He might be okay. Optimum doesn't feel like it. Feels like they're going off again. I'm not confident these tyres can last another 10 laps. Oh well, we'll soon find out. But if I suddenly start going about 5 seconds a lap slower, I'm going to be in big trouble from Rosberg. So I think I'm catching De La Rosa and Rosberg is catching me. Actually, he's really catching me, especially in the twisty bit. I might have to start being a bit naughty here. He's right on me. There's about three cars in shooting distance. That's like the top six. The top six are away. Yeah. I think my straight line speed and acceleration is as good as Rosberg's, if not better. So it's going to be very difficult for him to overtake unless I make a mistake on one of the corners. Did De La Rosa go in then? No, he stayed out. Oh, I'm not. I thought I was catching him, but maybe I'm not. Rosberg must fancy himself here. There's only one race after this, Abu Dhabi, and I can't do the maths in my head to see who's leading the championship with this. Where is Webber? Whoops! That's not going to help. He's going to have a run at me now on this bend. He's not a full second down now. He's going to have a right run on here. I need to brake late round here. Cut in early. Yeah, he won't get through there, right. He's still right behind me. Don't try anything crazy, Rosberg. But I think he might have been half a car alongside me there. Okay. Careful. Right, pulled out a little bit there. Let's go slow around here, but take the inside so he can't get past. Right, so I had a bit of a wobble there, but I think I'm still okay. Wish me luck. The race is going well. Third place. I'll settle with that, but I think De La Rosa is still out. How late is he going to pit? How late can he stay out on the prime tyres? I suppose that's good in a way, if I know the prime tyres last that long. But he's going to drop way down the order. Hamilton's still 12th. He's struggling to get in the points. Yeah, I'm 10 points behind Hamilton in the championship, who's currently lying second. If it finishes like this, I'll jump him, because you get... How much you get for third? 15 points. I'll jump him. Come on. Rosberg seems to have dropped back a little bit. Maybe his tyres are going off after that initial run. But it's this part of the circuit he generally gains on me. He's a lot quicker. Maybe he's got more downforce somewhere and less on the straights. This is annoying because I'm not gaining on De La Rosa or Alonso. The gap's staying the same, so my car's competitive. If only I kept Alonso behind me at the start when I was doing all that weaving. Right, Rosberg's close. Might go for a run again, but I doubt it. I'm playing this game with a controller, so it's not as precise as a steering wheel would be, so sometimes it seems that way. With a steering wheel, you can really be more precise on the corners. Here, you just got to, well, just go for it, really. It's like a difference between a round circle and a 50 pence piece. Hamilton's still 12. De La Rosa has stayed out again. These tyres must be so ropey. So he's done qualifying on those tyres, and now almost 14 laps. Surely they can't go on much longer. Come on, Alonso. Do a mistake. Yeah, see, Alonso's going away ever so slightly. Ferrari must be getting excited. My tyre there is yellow now, so that's starting to wear. So it looks like the right front tyre takes the most punishment out of all of them. It's going to be red in a couple of laps, and then I've got five more laps to go. I hope I don't have to make another pit stop. If I do, well, I'm not going to get any points, am I? But is Rosberg going to do anything risky? That's the main thing. He gets close here, but hasn't got the straight line speed advantage to get past me. This is before a time when they had curves, but you can press your magic button and get extra horsepower on the straight. I think De La Rosa's in. Right, so I'm up into second place. I think Webber, oh, that's well wide. I think Webber's going to come fourth. I think I've given Rosberg a chance there, have I? No, he hasn't taken it. Marvellous. What does this mean? Six laps to go, or thereabouts. First, Alonso, Ferrari. Second, me, McLaren. I'm represented by the button. Third is Rosberg, a magnificent third place in Mercedes if you stay there. And then fourth is Mark Webber. I don't know if he's sustained any car damage, but he must close the gap to Rosberg. If Rosberg could stay there, that would be very helpful. And if Alonso could slow down, that would also be very helpful. Hamilton's blown it. I think his championship might be over. At the moment, as I said, I don't know where Massa is. At the moment, there's five cars that possibly can win the championship. If Massa's not getting any points, that'll take him out of it. Interesting. Last race is Abu Dhabi. I think that's a quick circuit. I haven't raced there too much in computer games. But we'll see how we get on. I don't like the proximity of Rosberg. That's making me very nervous. That was 1.2 seconds slower. The tyres are starting to go off. It gets extremely close around here. I don't know if I'm going to be able to hold him back. Hamilton's in the points. I don't know if I'm going to be able to keep Rosberg behind me. I don't know where De La Rosa is now after that late pit stop. The car's not holding around here at all. I can hear Rosberg behind me. Is he going to risk something? I'm not making it easy for him, so although I'm slow, I'm cutting in quite early. Ooh, I said I was cutting in quite early, I wasn't early there. Whenever there's a gap, he is going to jump for it if there's sufficient time. There's Alonso there. Please spin, Alonso. Do it for me. You can't win the championship now, so do me a favour. I think Webber's catching up Rosberg and me. See? Yeah, I've noticed. How could they think I haven't noticed? If I hold Rosberg up enough, Webber could go past and that'd be self-defeating. Webber's currently 16 points ahead of me. Yeah. So if it finished like this, he'd probably only need to come third in the last race if I won and need to win the championship. Curses blast. Well, it's going to be a tight championship. If it finishes like this, at least I'll be in with a chance come the last race, which I didn't think would happen. Well, my fastest split so far, can't argue with that, even though the tyres are going off. Webber there, is he getting closer? Not by much. Second place from sixth would be a pretty good result. Ideally, I wanted to win, but the car's just not quick enough. And I've been holding people up at certain points, although it seems quite competitive now. I was holding them up particularly in the lap opening few laps. It settled down, we got gaps. Hamilton's spinning helped a bit because that held up a lot of the field. To a certain degree, when I pitted and come out again, there was pretty much a bit of space. That's wide. But yeah, Rosberg isn't as quick as he was. He's hanging on to me, but he's not as quick as he was. Lap 17 here of 21 coming to an end. So four laps to go. 18, 19, 20, 21. Hamilton still in the points, but in the low points. Webber fourth. Great championship leader Webber in fourth place. Wouldn't be a disaster for him because he's finishing ahead of teammate Vettel and Hamilton. I don't know where Vettel is after he had to change his nose cone. He's currently third in the championship. If Webber outscores him by 11 points here, then Vettel can't win. Can't afford to make too many mistakes now. I'm quite happy with this. How this has gone. I'm annoyed I'm not in the lead, but I've got to be happy with this. Alonso's up the road, but I'm not making any ground on him. Curses me. Mercedes be ecstatic to get Rosberg third. How has he managed that? Awesome. No other cars near us. Webber isn't making any grounds now. Inroads, I should say. That's my quickest split so far by a big chunk. Where's that come from? Can I beat a 1:12.4? Remember, my qualifying time is 1 minute 12.2. If I do that on Ward tyres, that'd be awesome. 1:11.7. Nice driving. That was the fastest lap of the race. Fastest lap of the race. That hasn't happened on any other circuit. Where did I pull that from? A 1:11.7. That's my quickest I've ever around here. I do not know where I pulled that from. Do you know, maybe I'm getting good at this game. I do pretty inconsistent laps though. Look at that, half a second slower. Yeah, I think I've lost all my time I made there. Where did a 1 minute 11.7 come from? If I'd done that in qualifying, that would have put me, I think, third. Whoops, cut the corner a bit there, but you can get away with that. Yeah, so I didn't really make much of a gap over Rosberg because this lap's so much slower. Is it going to stay the same to the end? If it rains in Abu Dhabi, the last race, that'll really help me. If it finishes like this, of course. But how often does it rain in Abu Dhabi? Never. But this is a simulated game, it might happen here. Yeah, Webber's nowhere, he's not going to do it. His tyres have gone. Mine aren't brilliant. I think Rosberg's might be ever so slightly better than mine, but not a great deal. Two laps left. Hamilton seems to be stuck where he is. I seem to be stuck where I am. Rosberg's stuck where he is. Well, that's the only interest in the race, really. Can Rosberg get past me? He's got absolutely zero chance of winning the race. It's the closest he's been for a while. God, I do not need this. I'm very slow around there on purpose. Tried to get him to back into the back of me, but I want him to stay ahead of Webber. So I can't be too aggressive, because at the moment he's taking points conveniently off Mark Webber for me. If Webber finishes there, I think that's 12 points. I would get 18 points, so I'd gain by 6, and he'd have a commanding 10-point lead. That is a commanding going into the last race. So you have to say Mark Webber at the moment is favourite to win the whole Blundering Championship. He never won the championship in the real world, that Australian guy. True Grit, I think he's called on Twitter, if you want to follow him. Ah, but yeah. Oh, it might be Aussie Grit, actually. I need to check that. Comment below what it is. Right. Can I hold Rosberg behind me for one more lap? I'm confident I can. Just go nice and slow, go early, because I have to force. If I force him the long way round, he's not going to do it. His only chance of getting round me is if I go off the track. Yeah, show off. He's beat my fastest lap. He's probably coming for fresh tyres. Rosberg, there's a chance to overtake. Not done it. So he's running out of places now, Rosberg. Although he's lightning fast behind me. Probably less than a couple of attempts. Right, there's another chance I go off there, which I haven't, because I've kept it nice and easy. There's one other chance. Cutting slow there. Right, there's only one other place he can overtake me. And that's if I outbrake myself around here. So I haven't. Actually, there's a couple of places. Here's another one. Oh, I've gone wide. Nope. Right, he's got one more chance, and that's if I go off the track at the end of here, but I won't do, because I'll go around deliberately slow. There we go. Make sure of it. Accelerate here. Now he's going to find it very difficult to get past me now. Tough luck, Rosberg. I've just got to keep it on, and you can't do it. Alonso then just finished. So how many seconds was that? I was very close to Alonso. Boom, second place. I've got a chance in the last race. I've got to be pleased with that. Finished ahead of Webber, Hamilton and Vettel. Didn't win, but job done. I won 11.7. Good.
Great race. Just fantastic.
Thank you, dude. Points. Yeah, Alonso won by 6.3 seconds. Webber fourth. De La Rosa fifth in the end. Awesome. Schumacher sixth. Kubiashi got eighth. Sutil seventh. That's good. Where's Vettel and Massa? I think Vettel and Massa might be out of the championship now. Yeah, great work from Mercedes there. Massa, yeah, look at that. Massa 10th. Hamilton 13th, not in the points. Vettel, yeah, I mean. Right, so let's have a look at this. Yeah, yeah. Vettel can't win. Vettel can't win. He's 26 points behind. So it's between Webber, me, and Hamilton now. No one else can win the championship, and Hamilton, well, Webber's big favourite there. So three cars got a chance going into the last round. How about that then? Great race. Only one round left. 18 rounds so far. Now Red Bull win the Constructors by 2 points. So join me for the next race in Abu Dhabi. I hope you liked the championship so far, including this race. Please comment below if you've got anything good to say. And until next time, take good care of yourself. And a very big goodbye.
Goodbye.